kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses. And we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power.
Pardon me?
The microphone?
See, nah, I don't know how to operate this little stuff.
Well, what a technical thing.
Turn the microphone on.
Okay.
This is the funeral service of Mother Susanna Sinan here at the Grace Church in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And you are following Voice of Sino here in the diaspora with Esoteric.
Praise the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. The Bible says everything we should give him thanks. Even though we are sad, but we also have to give thanks to the Almighty God. Hallelujah. We will thank the Bishop of the Church, the traditional choir this morning, for that beautiful selection. We're going to start our service, but we first of all want to welcome you all for the home-going service of our mother-in-law, Susanna Douglas-Snell. Oh Lord, please give her the strength this morning. It's not an easy thing to stay up here. Just seeing the woman a few months ago, and now seeing her in a different form is so hard. However, we got to do it. So we'll commence our service by an opening statement by our pastor, Pastor Rancis Salif, the senior pastor for the Christian Community Church.
Continue to hide in the light. So bless all of us. 1, if you don't come soon, 100 years from now, those of us who are here, maybe we may not be around, but we know where we are going. And there where she is now, so we're happy that we'll meet her one day again. Bless us, Lord, and keep us now. These and all the blessings we ask, in Jesus' name, and all of God's children say,
young traditional part of Christian Community Church. Hallelujah. verse 1 to 7. Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 1 to 7.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Mona. I'll be the granddaughter of this beautiful lady that in another place today. And the reading begins. Remember now that the greater in the days of the youth, while the evil days come not, nor the years draw light, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them. Verse 2, while the sun or the light or the moon or the stars be not darkened, nor the cloud return after the rain. Verse 3, in the day when the keepers of the house shall tremble, and the strong men shall bow down themselves, and the granite cease because they are few, and those ones of that look out of the window be darkened. Verse 4, and the door shall be shut into the streets, and the sound of the grinding is loud, and he shall rise up at the voice of the bird, and all the daughters of the musk shall be brought down. Verse 5, when also, sorry, I'm shaking. Also, when they shall be afraid of that which is high, and fear shall be in the way, and among trees shall flourish, and the grasshopper shall be burdened, and the desire shall be filled, because men of God to his long home, and the morning goes about the street. Verse 6. And ever in the silver cord and loose of the golden bow, we put serlings in the magic mouth. Oh, somebody please finish for me.
Hallelujah. And 7 says, the last verse, then shall the dust return to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall return unto God who gave it. Praise the Lord. Thus ends the reading of the word. Hallelujah. In our service,
that's the granddaughter of our late mother.
Can you imagine reading scripture reading at your own grandmother's funeral service? It's not an easy thing, friends. I was once here before, I would say twice, 2019, 2021. My son and my mom, all from the Christian community of the church. But we are strong in the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we'll continue our service this morning. At this time, we'll have a selection by the beautiful Christian Community Church Choir, Praise and Worship Team, Sister Jeanette, Sister Roslyn, everybody. If you are a praiser, we are all praisers in Christ. Hallelujah. So let's come on our feet.
In Jesus' name, God is good. And all the time, God is good to us. The Bible says, who's got to say, there's time for everything. There's time to be born, there's time to die. So we are celebrating our memorial today. In Jesus' name. We want to sing one of our favorite songs. When we are singing, she always wants to be with us this day. So we want to sing that song this morning.
Yeah!
You are following Voice of Sano here from the Grace Church on M Ward, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. It's the funeral service of Mother Susanna Sned Dober. Ladies and gentlemen, your fellow Voice of Sano here in the diaspora with Esoteric coming to you from the Grace Church here in Pennsylvania, Philadelphia.
The preacher said something to the people.
praise the Lord. So from that we are reading Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verses 1 to 7, it is reminding us, and this is before the coming of Christ, that in our youthful time, when we are very young, we should start a God business, get to know God for ourselves. Praise the Lord. We should get to do this God business when we are very, very young, because the time will come when we will not be able to do it again. Praise the Lord. The time and the reasons are on there. We should start it at an early age, but Scripture said, train the child away in which he should go, and when he shall grow, I will not depart from him. So when you get into, you know, Christianity, when you get into the Christian direction, you get to know the Lord of God and how Jesus died for you. Praise the Lord. The blessing you. Praise the Lord. So when you sick, you take it into Jesus. Praise the Lord. When you are broke, when you are frustrated, you just lean in on Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. But it's saying here again, at the very end here, when you get to know God for yourself, the reason is that the time will come when you're not hearing the birds singing, you're not hearing the nature playing, people, you know, doing what they usually do, and you'll hear what? Moaning, people will be moaning, people will be crying, because it's time for you to be. Praise the Lord. Amen. And this is the time when the scripture says here, it's like the call is broken on the picture of the bow, the golden bow is broken. We all know as believers that our body, the man is our spirit. The man is our spirit that lives in the body and has our soul. Praise the Lord. The soul of man is the one that learns all these intellectuality, all the people, the politics, and the praise the Lord. The body of man is the one that, you know, is the self-being, the things, the great things, and all of these things, so that the body can grow. Praise the Lord. But the spirit man is the one that focuses on the word of God, and that's how it grows. Praise the Lord. When you send your child to school, I think it's first reason I'm doing, they start going from day to day, because it's the soul that is focusing on it, on the right body, on the intellectual, the whole business, and the soul that is concerned with it, so that the child in the last picture will do a job. Praise the Lord. But the spirit wants to step the things of God, and your spirit starts to read the word of God, you start to fast and pray, praise the Lord, then it grows up. Praise the Lord. I want to welcome Pastor Payne. Pastor Payne is the assistant pastor. You get to know God for yourself. Your spirit man starts to grow. And when this system is broken, all your body, it's like, what happened to the Christ Apple? When we need a family, they need a baby, what? They need a friend, they need a family. They have to move in God. Praise the Lord. When we need a family, let them go to a baby. When you put the water in the pot, the clay pot, and that clay pot busts, the water of that breeze. That's how you describe death here. Praise the Lord. And that's what has happened to our man. Praise the Lord. But we are not so concerned about the wasted water. We are not so concerned about this valley that we place in the ground. Praise the Lord. We are concerned about what? Our spirit. Praise the Lord. And as the head pastor for the Christian Community Church, and my assistant here, testimony, and my mom, I'm going to say, our mother is with God in heaven. Praise the Lord. She is with God in heaven. Praise the Lord. She is with God in heaven. So I will start to praise her. And when I'm praising her, if you don't like the praise, I'm leaving her. And just check yourself to see how you can measure up. Amen. That's the intention of unity.
Yes.
It's not just praising the person for nothing. So since I've been doing what the Susanna Smith daughter at the Christian Community Church, she was a faithful wife. Praise the Lord. We have faithful wives here. Very faithful wife.
Praise the Lord.
Check me with faithful man. Not me for a while, but faithful while. Husband soon. Praise the Lord.
Then from there on, she was the mother of the church. Mother of the church. Yeah, mother of the church, she will always talk with me around this community that is that holy program. Are you a mother in your community, in your church, and your place of work? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Then the next, she was a very prayerful woman. Every time, most time, a baby in North East now come to check and start to, you know, clean up the thing, and then she will come. She died, she come. And the next thing I know, she got sick with body pastor like that. She needed that, and you know what? Pray! Yes. Praise the Lord! Because in the house of God, and when you do God well, there will be 10 pastors who body did that. No! She started to do what? Pray! She was a prayerful woman. Praise the Lord! And keeping praises all around you now. And you are a prayerful person. Praise the Lord! She was always an encourager of the up and coming young women in the church to aspire for the virtues of the virtuous woman in Proverbs 31. She was always encouraging the young women in our church so that they can read Proverbs 31 for themselves and see the virtues that are there now. What are the virtues? Are you somebody that you encourage other people, young people? Praise the Lord. Young girls, your younger sisters, your younger siblings, people in your community, you encourage people, praise the Lord, our Mother Day, and I'm proud to see you, and I'm testifying to you, praise the Lord. In the virtue that we are talking about, the virtue of fidelity, fidelity is being faithful, faithful to your husband, faithful to your wife, praise the Lord, virtue of fidelity, and the virtue of what? Industry. Praise the Lord. Industry is what you work with your hands to do what? To make things to sell. You know, some people they are begging, some people sold it. Our sister, she sold. Praise the Lord. It's an industry in itself. And that was a lot of quality. Praise the Lord. Now there was a time in the church, I wore the pants, and you know, they come to the bead. I'm back on the knees, and then they sleep. I mean, they jacket, I go to sleep back. And then she said, Pastor Sadie, I love what I ask you. Why are you wearing this suit? I said, but I'm not suit. You go in my hand, I said, I can wear this in my Paris. She said, you know what? In the head of the church now, and in that Paris, this is America. Praise the Lord. So I don't want to see you wearing this suit. I said, but what I told her, I'm wanting mommy. She said, praise the Lord. And she was singing. She was not finding her face. She was smiling. She said, I have to make you yellow. The following week on Mother Church, she said, come, let's feed the business with your suit. I asked you your word. Praise the Lord. She said, yes, I'm Susan, the post from Africa to the Mombasa. She go, I said, I'm buying mother, I'm buying tea. Praise the Lord. That's the kind of thing you want. And I bought tea with all the African slippers. Praise the Lord. Then we talk about praying. Charity. Charity is when you show love to people. Charity. They say faith, hope, and charity. But the greatest of these is what? Charity or love. Praise the Lord. She was a very loving person. Every time you went to her house, you would have food with you. Every time she had a sister, even if she disagreed with it, she was saying in a way that would not be offensive. Praise the Lord. She was a selfless person. Some people are about selfish, but she was about selfless person. Are you a selfless person? Praise the Lord. Or in our way, do you see other people's interest? Our mother did it. And I'm proud to say that all the women can testify to me in Jesus' name. And you are united. And I'm proud to say it. To the many that then try to improve your own attributes. Praise the Lord. The heart is kind. She was a very kind woman. She had kindness. Then she had what? Godly wisdom. And then she feared God. The fear of God is the beginning of what? Wisdom. Praise the Lord. She always feared God. Praise the Lord. didn't have you judging yourself. She will not be able to travel with so many of the young people in our church. Yeah. Praise the Lord. And those who know her, even those that were here last night for the week, Pastor Mother was here. He was saying more or less the same thing. Praise the Lord. And that heart is still over. And she didn't have a virtue. Pastor Waller didn't sit with me when I did this. I lay all the way in the office. And he didn't receive no room. We got a door. Praise the Lord. We never share those. But you're saying more or less the same thing. Praise the Lord. What are your virtues? What are your attributes? Or let me get being at me. What a good thing that will talk to you when you die. What a good thing that will say for you. Praise the Lord. If you have a good thing in you, it will die in the middle of man. You will have a change. Praise the Lord. We continue to go to the virtues of man. And she can express her opinion in an unwavering way. She always trusts the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. She shows compassion in resolving conflict. Praise the Lord. For example, last night, at the time of the week, I brought my client in. And this client, he goes to our church, the Christian Community Church, Spirit Week. Praise the Lord. My director has said, oh, this young man, he been working with, he been going to the church. And he said, carry him. Why? I said, because of the COVID. She said, COVID is over. You carry him. But before then, I need to bring the boy, and when I bring him, you cross from me, you will give me a mother. I said, I'm not doing for the church. And mother told him, she said, you say, why? You pass up for the church, and you call your boy, and I'm not doing it. So you have, you have to bring the boy to the church. Praise the Lord. So by then, when I'm done now, nobody told my mind up. My son, I have him in the church. She said, this Thanksgiving coming, your church will be having something. They are wanting to take through the church. I said, why? Praise the Lord. So I said, well, then, when I was speaking to this little woman, what is my brain? How would she know that we have a church? You know, I mentioned it in your hall. Praise the Lord. So I had to bring him back and we'll sit down over there and you will carry him. I said, well, I will bring him here because of oh, and I will give you all the big plate of food and drink. She passed. And he said, she went to heaven, she went to Jesus. I said, she went to Jesus. That's what we are here. And she, mother, dog, that very dog for the God of here. And that's why I brought him here. Praise the Lord. All I need to do, you are doing. All I know, I'm getting my pain. I want it. God, praise the Lord. But my God, definitely, with our love for the God of here, that's why I brought him. Praise the Lord. Washing the cross. Praise the Lord. That was the kind of person she was. Bring it back to church. Bring it back to them. Pastor said, bring it back to church. Praise the Lord. That was the kind of person she was. Let's continue to go. She was a very humble child of God, always smiling. And she had to make a point. If she had to make a point, she would not frown on someone like myself. Smile to make a point of frown. But she, if she had to make a point, she was found before she said it. Praise the Lord. That is the kind of person you call the type of pleasant personality. When you have a pleasant personality, you always wear a smile on your face. And that's the kind of person that she was. Praise the Lord. Wearing a smile on your face. Praise the Lord. The more you frown, then of course, you pray your own tongue and close. The last thing I want to mention about the Lord, that I want to say very clearly and check into the fact, she needs the Lord for blessing. Praise the Lord. Our mother is blessed. Praise the Lord. So today, as we mourn, we are not giving up. Because we know, just as Jesus said in John 6, and the man of God in the closing, he said, all that the Father has given unto me, that believe in me, no man can snatch anything from my hand.
And that was a eulogy. That's a eulogy where about a pastor. That's an excellent performance from the kids over there. Marvelous. So you're following Voice of Zion over here from the Grace Church in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. It's the funeral service of Mother Susanna Sinan Dubber.
district, Sano County, Republic of Liberia. Unto the union of the late Samson T. Pope Sr. and Teresa G. Pope. Marcel was the fifth of 34 children from her father. She was brought to Moravia in the early 60s by her late auntie, Ma Weadi, who raised her. Marcel was blessed with five children, Deborah, Blake, Prince, Mommy, and last one, Ajay. She left behind 22 grandchildren, 7 great-grands, 7 brothers and sisters, nieces, nephews, host of other relatives in the United States, Canada, and Liberia. Prior to Marcel migrating to the United States, Marcel served as one of the item members of the Liberian Market Association. Marcel was a woman of faith, a woman who strongly believed in the power of prayer. With a burning desire to serve God, she served as usher of the Piano Redemption Church of God in Lokentine, Moravia, the Republic of Liberia. In addition, Marcel was a social person. She was the light of every role she entered because of her sense of fashion. Yeah. Always loved to dress, and her beautiful smile always welcomed. Marcel touched the lives of many in the United States, Ghana, and Liberia. When she migrated to the U.S. in 2000, she was actively involved in her community, along with her late partner, Isha Dora, the founder of the Christian Community Church, where she served as mother until the cold hand of death took her from us, October 29, 2022. Marcel was part of many organizations. She was a founding member, a treasurer of the Nonprofit Development Association of Americas, and a member of the Sano County Association of Americas. She was also a member of the United Sidewalk Association of Americas, and the president for the Multicultural Community Family Services, EdoCentres. Marcel was very gracious person who contributed in many ways to us. She was a loving and peaceful mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, a sister, auntie, niece, a best friend to us. She was a caretaker of newly born babies in the family and those of other relatives and friends. She was very peaceful, sweet, hospitable, very caring, and always feeding everyone. She was a peacemaker, a prayer warrior of the family, relatives, friends, loved ones. She always exercised positive attitude in God's hearing. She hosted many in her home. She was always willing to offer support, whether monetarily, emotional, or spiritual. Overall, Marcel, my grandma, was a loving person
was the hands. She was the hands and feet of God at the place she worked. She worked at Mountain Run from 2001 until 2017 when she retired. Mansi was a sports lover. She was a fan of IE in Nigeria and a huge fan of Philadelphia Eagles. Mansi touched the lives of so many of us here today. Mansi was referred to in many ways. Some call her Auntie Mary, Mother Dora, Ma Susanna, Mary, Ma, Grandma, and my children call her Gigi. Whichever way you refer to her, there is no doubt she touched all our lives dearly. The question I keep asking myself, and it keep playing in my ear since October 29 when my grandma took her last breath, and the question remains the same. Who will replace a beautiful, selfless woman? The answer is no one. She was one of a kind. We will miss her because she dearly loved us, and we love her too. But God loves her best. Grandma?
Yeah, that's Shelly Keedoff right there reading the last scripture, Shuffle Grandma. Beautiful, the beautiful, the rest. Quite emotional, but she did a fantastic job.
I
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Shout out to Miles Davidson voice there.
Mom, you don't have no time. She said, The holes that we need to patch. because we don't know tomorrow. I can see the step right here, but the next one over there, I don't know. Let us forget grudges. Let us forget pride. Let us put our differences aside and face the passions that we need to be faced. Because when it comes as son, it know no Gisha, it know no person, it know nobody. Oh man. When you go, just in case, you have to see part we are speaking. So many of you that were so good to us have left us. But God has a final say to our life. Goodbye.
Praise the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. We have few churches, so shall it? You guys will be the last, the children, okay? So that was us. We're gonna call the Christian from another church. Yes. Everybody, the rest of the church will be held at the hall. You guys, we have 2 minutes here. So the mother's church that will speak, the children that will speak. So if you can't speak here right now, please for your peace. Go upstairs and do it. Please, help us, okay? I apologize. So we'll call the Christian from the church, our mother's church. Christian from the church, yeah? After the church, after the mother's church, we'll call free transition.
All right, guys, I think we're going to be bringing you part two shortly. We're going to go on a little break here and be back with more from the church after the tributes.
Thank you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, your following voice is Sino here, coming to you from the Grace Church here at Amwood, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. It's the funeral service of our mother here, Mother.
We stand before you representing the multicultural community family services, the Elder Circle, which is a program of the multicultural community family services, and the Calabash Pantry, a program of our organization where Ma Susanna, as she was affectionately known and called, volunteered. You know, when we lose an elder, we lose one of the touch bearers of our culture and our tradition. Ma Susanna indeed was a touch bearer. And so as the co-founders and executive director of the Multicultural Community Family Services, we stand here praying with you, members of the family, as to say back home, Yonamao, Yonama. This is difficult for NCFS as our shepherd, because just last Saturday, we buried another senior, another member of the Elder Circle, and we are grieved. And so without further ado, I want to give space to a special place that Ma Susanna felt so at home. She joined us in 2018, and she became a vibrant member of the Elder Circle. But I will let them tell their story and share a little bit of what Ma Susanna meant to them and to the work that was done by the Elder Circle. We thank you to the children who celebrated with us when we had our Elder Circles gathering. Our top one being one of those. Ma Susanna will always bring family so that it would be a part of time of Thanksgiving. And so, Ma Luisa, I pass it on to you.
Much of what has been said, we are here to confirm it. We know who she was and can I'm talking to. But we have for FAO to present to the family. Later is not gone. God is true. May her soul and all the soul rest in perfection and let resurrection
come.
And indeed, as that angel was given, Ma Susanna indeed was a seamstress. She would make pillows and skirts and earrings, jewelry, you name it. She and her team members did it together. This was the place where we now ask, what tribe are you? What country do you come from? It was a place where they met and gathered together as one and enjoyed each other's friendship. So thanks for sharing your mother with us.
Oh, that's a wonderful and great presentation there. The elder cycle.
You are funny, even though you've been
the normal course of the event, and I know all is wonderful. Stubborn, you're upset there. You're a good time. You always there. Mm-hmm. And you don't want to tell me, but I don't want to go kind of thing you're doing. The normal people will keep going. And I now saw you one day to make that meeting. And one day, we get $25 is wrong. So maybe I've never seen my boy one day say, what's it today? My hand shut.
Thank you.
So we want to give him this thing.
Even though we, it was taught me actually we were incarcerated, so we put this check in his name. Yes.
Y'all got to bear with him. Everybody say don't cry, don't cry, but you don't know this one. I'm trying. I will always be your man. My mother, if you know me, you know my mother, I will cry for her every day. If I can change place, I'll take her place right now. Woman doing the war, she's too evil a man with a gun. He said, you're not taking my son from me. You tell me not to cry for her. She said, you're not taking my son. The gun in her face. I will cry for her every day. But before I do that, I just want to tell everybody thank you. Everything you said, you're setting for the woman we know. Everybody call her differently. I call her mom. She called me Lies Bomb. If you know me, you know who am I to her. A Lies Bomb. So when I cry, I'm not crying because I don't want to be your man. I'm crying because I have pain for her. And I will continue to cry because if I don't cry for her, she will never know how much I love her while she's laying there. So thanks everybody for coming. Thank you for all the tribulation and everything you said about her. We love you. But this woman right here, they say the mother doesn't have to bury the child, but I will take her place and let her bury me. I will take her place anytime.
It's a tough one there, a difficult one there for the brother.
Save those who are in spirit.
Amen. The Lord consoles the brokenhearted. So if you don't believe, turn your life to Christ. As time goes on, you will heal all wounds. So let's bow our heads. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. We have come, O Lord, to share the grief with the family. But Father, we know that you have called our mother home because it is time for her to come home. And so, Lord, we as a Christians, Father, we know that we have no cause to grieve because it is the appointed time and you call her home. But Lord, we pray for the children she left behind. We pray for the grandchildren she left behind. We pray for the nephews and nieces she left behind. Father, you know everyone played a role in her life. Though she deceased, but Father, we know that you want to provide her peace and happiness and joy again. So that Father, one day we will join her in glory. Father, we thank you. We bless you, Father. As the children continue to go back to their places where they came from, Father, let them be strong in faith. Those that have churches, let them hold on to their churches. Because Lord, you are in church now. And Lord, we just thank you for your life. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Finally, before I take my seat, it's an open invitation to the family. I would like to see the family visit your mother's church tomorrow. That's all you can do for the Christian community church where your mother has been all through the years. So it's around 5117 Chester Avenue. Almost everybody that left Philadelphia knows the address. So we appreciate if you stop by tomorrow to fellowship with us before you can return to your respective places. Thank you.
Sick and succinct and to the point.
JFK Airport on November 27th at 6 p.m. It's going to arrive in Brussels the next day at 7. It's going to leave Brussels at 12 p.m. and it's going to arrive in Morovia at 8:15 the same day. Please continue to pray for the family as they're going to travel. Please continue to remember them and uplift them in your prayers. They're going to need you. as he take his journey, his final journey with their mother to take her home to her final resting place. So we are not going to be going to a grave today. So after here, the family wants you to join them upstairs for continued celebration of our mother. So please join your family. The recessional, the clergy is going to get out first, then the casket, and then the family. So everything is going to be done here. So I know you're going to be very patient and be honored and stay in your seat and respect the family and let them get out. Okay?
Amen.
Thank you. And God bless you. Four bearers, I will need men on the side to help us put the casket down. So you know what we did yesterday. If you were blessed enough, you know we wore there. Just wait for us to do that after the benediction. God bless you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you've been following Voice of Sino here, live from the Grace Church on Amwood, Philadelphia, PA. It's the funeral service of our mother, Susanna Snendubber. See the building here, is, the church is fully up to capacity. So, ladies and gentlemen, you've been following Voice of Sano here in the diaspora with Esoteric coming to you from the Grace Church here. It's a funeral service of Mother Susanna Dubber here.
Looking fresh, man. Come on, bet JJ. Bet JJ. Oh.
So, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for following Voice of Sound here. This is our first segment of the funeral service here of our mother. We'll be back with part two of this coverage. Keep following Voice of Sound. We have a YouTube platform as well. You can follow us on YouTube, Madison Freeman. You just type in Madison Freeman, MadisonFreeman, and we have a lot of videos out there to watch. Thanks for following us. We'll be back with part two.